was like, if he can do it, and you can do. Remember that song said that? It was a Scatman dance song. It said, if I can do it,
on your trip home now.
Thank you. No telling what I might get into.
Kills me. I'll see you tonight too, Robert. Bye. Alright, Joey. Then straight ahead, and then once you get onto the carpet, the desk is about 10 feet up on your right.
Okay. Well, Yafo doesn't have beer, otherwise I'd say time to go get wasted. Oh, we gotta open the door?
It's open. It's open for me. There you go.
Well, let's say. Hello.
Hi.
I'm about to leave now.
Can I
need
sign out?
Yes, please.
So, you have a ride?
Yeah, he's going to
a
restaurant.
So, yeah, you're good to go.
And I can
throw it away for you.
What should I do with my tag?
I'll throw it away. Unless you
want to
keep it.
No, I don't need to keep it. Okay. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you too.
Have a nice day.
You too.
I was going to shake your hand. But
yeah, I was reaching for it.
Oh, sorry. Have a nice day.
Yeah, you too.
And how old are you? Hmm? How old are you?
Oh, I'm 24.
Oh, so am I, actually.
Oh, yeah, that's cool.
Same age.
All right, Joey, did you turn around and kind of follow my voice?
Yes.
We're coming towards the front door to you right there.
Oh, you met plenty of blind people as an O&M, but never a deaf-blind person.
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I've met quite a few during my internship.
Oh, yeah, they'll teach you in the center. But see, even at the center, because it's so blind-centric, I didn't get the deaf-blind education like I probably should have gotten. See? And that road that you can kind of hear in the distance, that's not central. That's, I believe it would be to the left, wouldn't it?
We're gonna go right, because Yafo's on Central.
Yeah.
But the one, the other way is the highway, I think.
Yeah, that's the high. That's Independence.
Yeah.
Used to be able to hear Independence from my grandma and grandpa's place on Shenandoah.
Oh, okay.
Which I don't know if you know where that is.
It sounds familiar. I bet I would recognize it if I saw it.
You take a left on Pecan. It's in Chantilly. Like you go.
Oh, yeah.
There's a street you go through with some speed bumps and some train tracks.
Okay.
I've been there in years, but I still remember it.
Yeah.
Memory's insane.
That's good.
What made you want to be an O&M?
So I'm 34. And my undergrad, which I got, you know, a number of years ago now, is in self-contained special education. So I've been a special ed teacher for about 12 years. And I had my son about 5 years ago, or 5 years ago, he's five. And around that time, I kind of switched to teaching part-time and decided to go back to grad school. And I got interested in O&M. The sidewalk goes a little to the right.
Yeah, to the right or left?
To the right.
I hate when they do this. Oh, and then they got the new ones because no resident would ever buy or rent a luxury apartment with these goofy sidewalks.
Yeah.
I wouldn't.
So I had a student in one of my self-contained classes who was a young lady who got O&M. And I honestly didn't even know what it was until she had that service. And I kind of became friends with the O&M that would come see her and got interested in it that way. And so when I switched to working part-time to be home with my son, I started doing grad school.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That sounds fun.
Yeah.
But yeah, that Moore Square. Have you ever been on the Jacksonville Skyway in Florida?
No, I haven't. I do have family in Jacksonville, but I have not.
Oh, well, it's like drug addict city.
Oh, okay.
It's like, Daddy's like, that is the worst drug addict area I've ever seen.
Okay.
On the, because, and you know, the trains are dilapidated. Mm-hmm. Jacksonville sucks. It does. Like, there's a reason it's easy to park downtown, y'all.
Yeah. Yeah.
In a major city. Going across here?
Let's go down to the next one because this is a five-way intersection and it's like...
Oh, yeah.
Even for me, it's not
heavy. It's a five-way, yeah. Oh, you want to go down to Hawthorne? That's the doozy.
Here, come to your left a little bit. The sidewalk is bent. Huh? We're not in a mobility lesson anymore, so I won't make it figure it out.
Oh, well.
Yeah, just kind of...
Well, let's go. Let's take it slow. I mean, you ain't got nowhere to be, do you? You ain't got nowhere to be, do you? Oh, you know, that's rough. Is this doozy?
Yeah, that corner is a little funny. It's kind of like the sidewalk opens up really wide and then
it's
very slowly.
Oh, yeah, and then it goes narrow. You could tell when there's an apartment block. Because, you know, like the next block we're going to get some really bad sidewalks.
Yeah.
With the damn railroad tracks. You know, they're going to make this area a social district. They need to just go. Yeah, but you know what? Somebody's going to end up getting real injured on one of the bad sidewalks. You know what I really wish they would do? It would be a political non-starter. They wouldn't be able to do this. It's narrow. So you know how they have central to one lane in each direction? That's all you really need over here because people avoid this part of central because it's busy and congested. So obviously the traffic demand, you know, there are not enough people for, you know, people treat this road like it's, you know, not a thoroughfare, so might as well just respond to the demand and widen the sidewalks. Because people are letting us have it, so take it. They did something like that in Tampa, Florida. In downtown Tampa, they had road that they have signalized intersections but no one drives on it. People don't drive on it. So what they did was, they just made them all stop signs.
Okay.
Have you ever spent this much time in the busy areas of Charlotte?
So the school that I have worked at for 10 years is in Uptown.
Oh, wow.
It's on South Davidson Street. So it's not, it is in like a, I mean, it's in Uptown, so it's a busy area, but yeah. It's a little bit on the outskirts.
Oh, yeah. Davidson Street. See, Davidson
Street. There's
an
overhanging wire right in front of you. Put your
wires.
Yeah. There we go.
It's like they got rid of the, oh, you know all that construction they got on Central? They're undergrounding it.
Oh, okay.
They're undergrounding the power lines, which, hey, about 2 days late and $2 short, but that's the way our city is.
Alright, we're right here at the crossing. You want to take my arm?
Yeah. Oh, you know where we're going to go right past? Thirsty Beaver.
I've heard of that one. I haven't been there.
Oh, it's so fun.
I've only been to one brewery in this part of town, and I'm trying to remember.
It's not a brewery, it's
across.
A bar.
Oh, okay. We're across if you want. But,
No, it's a bar. It's like once you cross Hawthorne, 1225 Central. It's the one with those apartment blocks. That, see what I mean? It's a crap sidewalk.
Yeah, that part is especially bad, you're right.
And when you go, it's like there's this apartment complex that it looks like disconnected from each other.
Here, take my arm again really quick. We're gonna here's a driveway and somebody's waiting.
Yeah. There's like, you'll see it's this place, little tiny place that got condos around it, like three sides of it. That's the Thirsty Beaver.
Okay. I can picture where it is. I just haven't been in it.
And what happened was the reason why it's like that, they wanted to buy this development. developers wanted to buy the whole property, and they even gave, to give the Thirsty Beaver $3 million. The Thirsty Beaver wanted to keep their bar, and they told them to get bent. So they said, we'll just build around you. And Beaver's like, okay. And then it ended up...
Huh? That's right, I can picture that now. I feel like that story sounds familiar.
Yeah, so Beaver's like, okay, and then they end up getting legendary status.
Yeah.
Because people like, you know, everyone likes to support the underdog, you know?
Yeah.
So they get legendary status, and they, people like to go there, and their core crowd still goes there. Which is Harley Davidson, they didn't have parking if you're a motorcycle. They don't have park. There's a park.com lot about next to it.
Okay.
But other than that, they don't really have a place to park.
Yeah. What corner is Yafo on?
By Beaver.
To the left?
Yeah.
Okay.
Beaver be on the left.
Oh, yeah, there it is. Okay, yeah.
That's awesome. You should see the scenery.
Alright, so we're
gonna turn. Yeah, you come from the streetcar station on Sunnyside. You have to cross Hawthorne and Central.
Yeah.
I don't like the streetcar. Because, see, it has all the issues that are associated with taking the bus, i.e. getting stuck in traffic.
Mm-hmm.
And it has the drawbacks of the train. Like, you know how on the bus, they teach you basically to interact with the driver?
Yeah.
But you can't do that because the streetcars are set up like the train.
Oh, yeah.
You know. So now you have, like, you know, so now you have all the drawbacks, none of the perks. I mean, the train you take when you have to, like, if you're going to go some places, it'd be much better to take the train even with the, can't get the conductor's attention.
Yeah.
But always try to sit behind the conductor because you never know when some crazy person is going to come on there and you're going to have to tap on the window.
Yeah.
Here comes Beaver. And all its dive bar glory.
Uh-huh.
See,
look at
Yafo's.
Them down here. I remember hearing that story now that you reminded me.
Oh, you'll know on Twitter. Sundays, 6 to 8, they have live music. You'll hear it all the way from the intersection. Oh my god, and look at the music. Sound like a recording studio.
Is a musician and he plays at bars and breweries sometimes.
Most bars and breweries sound like an echo chamber.
Yeah, he hasn't recently. He definitely.
See, I don't know if you can see
younger.
Here, but they have soundproofing things on the walls. I don't know if you can see in it. It's tiny.
Yeah, I can't see inside, but let's go to the center.
It sounds good. Like you can't even hear the busy road. Like you can outside, but when you're inside, like you know how space that small?
Yeah.
And they keep the door open so like to make the space feel a little bigger.
Yeah.
You can't even hear the road when the music's playing.
Uh-huh.
You can't even hear the road. It's so good.
Nice.
So awesome.
Side sidewalk sucks a whole lot.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, here comes the damn railroad tracks.
Yeah,
somebody's gonna slip and fall on this. Tipsy. And the city's gonna be like, I don't know why no one told us about the sidewalks, you probably didn't listen, you probably knew about it. Because we almost walked the whole thing on our lesson. Gonna be weird to see because they're gonna have to go from strictly enforcing the towing, because if they're gonna encourage customers to walk with drinks between one another, they're gonna have to do the same thing at the parking, because yeah. Otherwise the social district's not gonna work.
Yeah, yeah.
It looks pretty out here now.
It is.
I'm pretty good at beating pavement.
Uh-huh, you are.
See, Central does this where it's like all quiet and, you know?
Yeah, oh yeah. It's like whenever you want to hear something, that's...
Like, yeah, you know how I would stop to make sure I heard a car coming?
Yeah.
Make sure I go the right way? Mm-hmm. And it would get like this. So you see, like, nothing coming. It would get just like this.
Alright, so you're good for me to leave you at Yatho?
Yes.
Okay.
You parked all the way over here.
Yeah, I parked at Sherwin Williams. I think I would probably park. Yeah, I was gonna park at the agency and walk down to our starting point, but I put some traffic on the way in. I need to park a little closer.
See, the traffic by the agency is messed up. Because they're, like I said, they're undergrounding the line.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah.
But here's that construction.
Yeah, it's across the street.
Yeah.
But that's what was messing us up earlier.
Oh, yeah.
All right, you got a curb to your right. We're going to step up on it. And then there's, like, 2-3 stairs right in front of you.
Oh, yeah. And the bus stop is over. You go down the street and you take a... It's over somewhere, isn't it?
I'm not sure. Do you need that information? Or do
yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I kind of could use it.
Okay, here, let's decide all of
it. You know, I can ask somebody when I leave.
You could. Bring you up to the line and start to stand right here for a sec. Let me pull out my phone. And I'll let you bring
up those
numbers. And where are you going from here? Just home?
Downtown, CTC. I eat in the Charlotte Urination Center.
So my phone says that there is a stop at Central and Clement.
Oh, so to the left.
Yes, to the left.
Mm-hmm.
And it looks like it's on the other side of the street.
Is that a cross?
I'm sorry. No, there is one on the side of the street.
Yeah, it's the inbound side.
Yeah.
This one.
Yep. Are you good with that or?
Oh yeah, I'm good.
Okay, cool. Do you want me to take you up to the line or to the register?
Yeah.
Okay.
So what do you think? Along for some as monumental as my last O&M lesson.
I was honored to be here.
Thank you.
All right, Joey, I'm going to leave you at the counter here. They're ready for you to order. It's right here in front of you. Oh, you give me a hug?
Yes.
So call Brad and he can get in touch with me if you need anything, okay?
Okay, thank you.
All right, bye, Joey.
Bye.
How are you today, sir?
Oh, I'm doing great.
Love it.
I will have a chicken shawarma bowl with rice.
Sounds good to me.
And some grape leaves. Big old cup of grape leaves if you got them.
So you want some rice, some grape leaves. Do you want any salad or anything in there, man?
What kind of salad you got?
We got like kale crunch, romaine, spinach and kale.
No, I'm good.
Good, perfect. And you want any hummus, tzatziki, or bamgamish on there?
Yes.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
You want like all three of everything?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, friend. And besides grape leaves, we usually recommend tomato cucumber salad and sumac onions. Does that sound good?
And what onions?
And sumac onions.
Ah, fellas.
Yeah. Do you want the cucumber tomato salad as well?
No, thanks.
No, thanks? All right. Did you want any, like, cabbage slaw, pickles, or anything like that?
I think I'm good.
Think you're good? Just
yeah.
Grape leaves, onions, and shawarma chicken on the rice?
Yes.
Alrighty.
Right.
Do you want the lemon tahini sauce that goes with it?
Yes, please.
Alright, friend.
And I would like to sit out.
Say again, sir?
Yeah, you got the outside chairs open?
The outside chairs?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
I'll sit out there.
Sounds good to me.
Hmm?
Alright. And hey, were you getting a drink today, sir?
Yes.
Alrighty.
You got Mexican Coca-Cola?
We do not, but we do have a really good cucumber limeade, the regular soda fountain, as well as sweet tea, unsweet tea, strawberry, lemonade.
I want me a Coca-Cola with mild ice or a Pepsi.
That sounds good, sir. Alright, sir. The total is going to be $15.16 today, okay?
Alright. See, that's how we fold our $10 bills.
I love that. That's how you fold your fives. And you got any change on you, sir?
Do what?
Do you have any change on you, sir?
No.
No?
You know what? I have another bill.
I got you. Thank you, sir.
So, yeah, I don't know why you did that. Did you?
All right, friend. $4.84 is your change. All $1 bills, obviously.
Thank you.
And you said Coke without ice, correct?
Yes.
Yeah, you want the lemon straw as well?
Yes, please.
Yep. Here, I'm going to go get that for you.
Thank you.
Prepare your food and have it ready in just a moment. You did say you wanted to sit outside?
Yes.
Perfect.
I am on my way. Can you bring it to me outside?
Yeah, I'll bring it to you, man.
I do think it's a girl.
Oh, yes, sunlight.